bit about the homeless issue here.
It's gotten worse, but
it's getting better. How about tell me about your job, your bartender job? Let's skip this.
I work at a Roadhouse Bar off of Main Street.
It's
right next to the B Stadium. They do a lot of games. It keeps us busy. But we sell burgers and make good cocktails. We won the World Burger Championship in 2012. So that really kind of put us on the map. So I'm really happy to work for a company that takes good care of me. And Lyft driving is kind of like, you know.
Cool. Yeah. Have you, well, the channel is focusing on homeless. Have you deal with like homeless people around the bar, around the area? Well, this channel is also focused on substance abuse. So how did you handle with people who's really drunk? I mean, have you ever had to like help them to get in water or something like in a bar?
All the time.
Oh,
way too hot. Yeah.
Okay.
I'll give food away too if I have.
Oh, cool. What's your favorite drink? What is the most request from the customer?
Most requests?
Yeah.
Oh man, I sell a lot of front row. Ah. I say whiskey sours.
Okay. How long have you been bartender?
I've worked in the industry for on and on 12 years.
Okay.
I've been bartending probably close to 5 or 9.
And what made you want to work at a bar after you get your degree in English, college in English? Why would you want to pursue?
You know, I think it was just the environment's what I wanted to do. I don't know, I kind of got here just kind of in a string of events.
Right.
In the business with my dad.
Okay.
We owned a repair shop for years. So, you know, after that, he got cancer and we shut down the shop.
Okay.
Never went back into the field. I just felt like I would need to learn everything again.
Okay. So, all right. That's
maybe a lack of confidence to go back.
I don't think so.
Maybe the money.
Okay. What is the most interesting thing? I mean, tell me a little more interesting happened in working as a bartender.
Interesting?
Yeah. The most memorable thing.
You know, I've had everything from good memories to bad memories. So, you know, maybe I'll hit one of each. How's that?
Okay.
So, good memory is seeing a friend come in that I hadn't seen in a long time. We reconnected, and now we're a lot closer.
Okay.
You know, I've had a lot of good tips along the way.
Right.
I've had people help me with my car when it broke down late at night.
Okay.
Or give me a ride.
Okay.
You know, you get a lot of benefits from being a bartender, but I'll tell you some of the negative stuff that comes with it is the stress.
Okay.
The stress is that you are constantly at the will of someone else's pace and speed, and you're constantly changing that. In addition to all of that stress that you deal with normal stuff for the bar, you also get random things like, I'll give you an example. Someone gets drunk and rowdy and angry and
violent,
you kick them out, right?
Right.
You know, they get out and they're drunk and they get out to their car and they sideswipe a customer's car. You know, what else can happen? You know, we had a guy who was on meth.
Okay.
He was aggressive, he was angry, hyped up, you could tell he was on drugs of some sort, likely some amphetamine.
Do you have to pull him up or what?
You know, what happened was he brought a 9-iron and just started beating at the door.
What do you do?
To the point where we had to chase him down and kind of help and protect the rest of the crew. And it's scary stuff like that happens. You know, we also had the riots last summer and we had to shut down. Early, multiple nights.
Okay.
So yeah, it was an interesting last year and a half. I really tried my
your best
experience. I tried my best, but it really tried my patience for if I wanted to stay in the industry, and I survived it. So I think I do.
Okay, so, I thank you, Richard.
I appreciate it.